All right, Shalom. I can first and foremost, I want to give all praise and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahusha. Double honor to the apostles, that great millstone. Salutation to the brothers out there that are teaching his word in all true faith and sincerity, man. And I just want to title this lesson, Are You Grounded? Because as we get closer and closer, man, the Lord is he's sifting out the good seed, you know what I mean?
Who is his chosen, man?
Yeah, I mean, because just like how rice, you cook rice, you know, you got to strain it and get all the starch and shit out, all that other shit, that bullshit out for it, man. Yeah, I mean, and there's a time and season for everything. And this is the time when niggas get caught up in these term dodgers again, man. That and us showing who the Lord dealing with and showing that these true reprobates, true colors, man. Yeah, I mean. This Matthew 13:18, hear ye therefore the parable of the sower, where one heareth the word of the kingdom and understandeth not. Then cometh the wicked one and catcheth away that which was sown in his heart. This is he which
received seed by the wayside. Yeah, so really
it ain't gonna be for you anyway.
You know what I mean? It was just for you to come up and get your judgment.
Word, man, that was just a quick, swift death. You know what I mean?
The Lord, he was made in vain.
You were just an extra in the movie. You know what I mean?
It says, but he
that receives seed into the stony places, the same as he that heareth the word and anon with joy receiveth it.
Yet hath he himself
not root in so like, yet hath he not root in himself, but dureth for a while. Or with tribulation or persecution arises because of the word, by and by he is offended. So, really,
it wasn't for you either. Matter of fact, because
we're gonna go through tribulation, man, and all that, and you shouldn't be offended of the word because the Lord, he's an austere man. And it tells you, blessed is he that is not offended in me.
Yeah, I mean, this is
it's 1 John 2.
And
verse 19, they went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they have been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us. But they went out that they might be made manifest that they were not all of us. Yeah, kind of. Yeah, because they would no doubt have continued. Whatever it is, man, you know this the truth. You would have no doubt continued, man. You know what I mean?
Because now you know,
you be looking at certain brothers or whatever it is, and you probably like, I don't know about, you know what I mean? It shouldn't be like that. You see what I'm saying?
You have no doubt.
Continue like, yeah, that he got to be a man of the Lord. You know what I mean? But you niggas, you ain't enduring it to the end, man. You know what I mean? You get offended. You get butt hurt. You know what I mean?
And by and by, he was offended.
I tell you, blessed is he that is not offended in me. Matter of fact, let me get that. This,
Matthew chapter 11.
Verse 6.
And blessed is he whosoever shall not
be offended in me.
See, because,
when you're offended, man, that means, you don't agree with it.
Which means you're going against,
actually, you're fulfilling Revelations on the 22nd chapter, man. That because when you agree, you add or taking away from it that you don't agree with. You see what I'm saying? You know what I mean?
This
is Matthew 13:22. He also that receives seed among the thorns is he that heareth the word, and the care of this world and the deceitfulness of the riches choke the word, and he becometh unfruitful. Yeah, man, because this fucking wicked ass place,
man, is a place full of lust, man.
Anything you can think of, you can feel your desires here, man. Your wicked desires, because
even like fucking
the riches of this world, it's not just including money, man. Just to fulfill your
carnality
fucking mind, man. Because you fucking carnal, man. Yeah, I mean, because the riches of this world is not compared to what it's not even comparable to what the riches we got on the other side. Heavenly riches, man.
Yeah, I mean, you fulfill your lust over here.
What is it? It choked you, man.
Like, cause it gets to a certain point where you ain't gonna even want to
do this no more, man.
You become unfruitful. You don't want to
do videos. You don't want to go out into the highways and byways. You just want to fulfill your lust, man. Fulfill your corner ass flesh, which is fucking is
dirty rags, man. And it says on the
verse 23. But he that receives seed into
the good ground is
he that heareth the word and understandeth it, which also beareth fruit and bringeth forth some 100-fold, some 60, and some 30. Yeah, man, that's, hey, that's, you got to pray that you part of that, the one that was on the planet on the good side, man, the good ground, man. Let you know you rooted because, It's a lot of doctors and shit out here, man, that you can get fucking swayed by, you know. Let me get there.
It's a lot of doctors you can get
swayed by, man. Let's
see. This is on 2 Corinthians
chapter 2, verse 11. Lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. Because it's a lot of Satan devices, man. Woman, yeah, I mean, money, and all type of shit of this world. Carnal shit, man. And they try to get so-called spiritual and have different philosophies and shit, man. It gets corner in those philosophies too, man. And you got to hope that you're grounded and matured in this truth, because when you get into it, you just can't come to this truth straight out the Baptist church, man. You got to be watching your videos. You got to study. Yeah, you know I mean? You just can't come on the high, you know, you see the brothers on the highways. You're gonna fucking get judged, man. And you're going to be the one that's marked, that hear the word and understand it not. Yeah, you know I mean, it was meant for you to just to hear it.
So the Lord can
kill you, man. That's how righteous the Lord is. Well, you come to this camp, when you come to the camp, you gotta be planted on the good soil, man.
Cause let's see, this
Hebrews chapter 5, verse 12. For when the time ye ought to be teachers, ye have need that one teach you again,
which be the first principles of the oracles of the Most High.
So yeah, everything that you learn, you gotta throw it up again, man. Everything that you got in your mind, you gotta pluck it up, man. You gotta pluck it up. And then you have that new seed planted in you.
When you first watch the videos,
you know, you follow the scriptures, you know what I mean?
Look at the research, look at different words in the
blue letter. Go to the Greek, the Hebrew,
Latin, you know what I mean? You know? And are become such
as have need milk and not a strong meat. Yeah, because baby, you know what I mean? Matter of fact, I'm gonna keep on going into it. This is verse 13. For everyone that uses milk is unskillful
in the word of righteousness.
For he is a babe. Yeah,
you ain't got no experience, man.
So
when you a babe, you can form your head.
When you're a babe, the mom forms the baby head to conform it to what how she wanted. You know what I mean? But this with this truth,
you gotta
grow in this thing. You gotta be grounded too, cause you're not grounded, you're not gonna grow. You're not gonna get no nutrients, man.
You know. But strong meat belongs
to them that are of full age, even those by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil. And that's the point, man. You gotta be able to discern what's good and evil, man. You gotta let that truth grow on you, man. It has to grow, man. You gotta be planted on that good ground. You gotta be grounded. Matter of fact,
let me see. See if I can find a word grounded. Matter of fact, let me go to etymology. This is Ephesians 3:17,
that Hamashiach may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye being rooted and grounded in love. See, you gotta be rooted and grounded in this love, man. This truth, man. Yeah, I mean, I'm finna go to the blue letter in this, and we're grounded.
See. And it's Strong's G
2310, and it's Thamaleo. And it said
to lay found
the foundation, to found, to make stable, establish. Yeah, you know I mean, so that's the it's a base, man. Yeah, you know I mean, when you ground it, it's like a base. You can't knock a square over. You can't knock a base over. The base is that's it. When you build
something, you build
on top of something that's stable, man. That's
established, you know. This is Ephesians
chapter
4:14.
That we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive. Yeah, man, because a lot of these niggas, man, they get to the point where they don't even believe no more, but they gotta tell they fought the devil. They try to take niggas down with them too, man. Yeah, I mean, they get to the point where they don't believe no more, but they want to take niggas out too, with them, man.
There's an old sin in the
world. I gotta take I'm not going out by myself. You gotta take a couple one with me. Yeah, I mean. And that's what you niggas do, man. Y'all lie and wait. Y'all wait on the new trend to come out of doctrines. Nigga got swept up by the flat earth and shit. And that means you ain't even grounding in this truth, man. You was a fucking a malnourished child. You was a fucking infant still, man.
You know, it gets to a certain point
when you, however long you in this truth, and you're not progressing, that's a problem, man. That means you're not being rooted. Well, I said earlier, if you looking like I don't know about that brother, whatever, that means you gotta you know, check that dude or whatever. You know what I mean, see what's going on, because if it was like that, they would have no doubt continue, man.
This song. God, this Psalms
chapter 1 and verse 1. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Yeah, because a lot of you dudes, man, you be
looking in the other shit. Yeah, I mean, that means you don't believe. You walking in the counsel of the ungodly, you still.
They say you know, you still gonna hang with, not hang with niggas, but you gonna be around niggas and shit. Yeah, I mean, fucking, you be watching these videos of flat earth, trying to see if it's real. You know what I mean? And I mean, that means you're not grounded, man. That means you don't even believe. And the scriptures tell you how, you know what I mean? They tell you in Apocrypha, I believe it's in here, who have made the depths and the heights. I mean, you know, it goes into the, tell you, you going to mathematics,
the formula of a
sphere. Yeah, I mean, the scriptures describe that, man. Yeah, I mean the diameter and all that, man. It lets you know it when it describes the formula of a sphere, man. It lets you know it's a circle, man, and not a flat circle, nigga. Yeah, I mean, this is verse 2, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, Yahweh Shemel Shai, and in his law doth he meditate day and night, because your mind is always on these scriptures, man. Everything you see, you got a scripture about it, man. Oh, I said a natural man cannot receive
because he's spiritually discerned. Everything, you got a
scripture about it, man. You know what I mean? I just seen it was 14 minutes and 41 seconds when I just looked up on it, man. Yeah, I mean, niggas don't pay attention to that.
You know,
Verse 3, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Yeah, a tree that, because that lets you know is a tree that's not going to have no droughts. And it said rivers of water, it's living water. Water is continually, the Lord is continually dwelling in you, man. It said out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. So it's not just a river. It's plenty of rivers, man. Many rivers.
That lets you know you're going to
continue to get this food, man. You're going to continue to get nourished, man. You're going to continue to grow. He said a tree planted. You know what I mean?
It says that
that bringeth forth his fruit in his season, his leaf also shall not wither. Because, hey, that's beautiful, man.
That's beautiful. And whosoever he doeth shall,
when whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. And that ain't talking about prospering in fucking America, man. They're talking about getting this knowledge, continue to get this truth, man. Continue to your knowledge and wisdom continue to grow, man. You know what I mean?
Verse 4.
The ungodly are not so, but they are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Yeah, man. Because when the chaff, you know, like with the weed and shit.
You get that and you separate the
chaff. The wind blows it away and it separates it, man. Because you're going to get blown away by this wind of doctrine. Then you're going to get blown away with these nuclear winds, man. The ICBMs, man. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. So all these doctrines and shit is gonna perish, man.
Everything that you try to, you know,
do, man, you're gonna be disappointed, you know. But that was it, Aki, man. I hope it was edifying, man. Until the next time, hey, Shalom.